Now, we all know that work can be stressful no matter what you do for a living, but at what point does it become a much bigger problem? The World Health Organization is taking burnout more seriously than ever.
Experts say chronic workplace stress is behind it. Joining us this morning to talk more about this is Steve McClatchy, author of the New York Times best-selling book, Decide, Work Smarter, Reduce Your Stress, and Lead by Example. Welcome.
Thank you for having me.
We're excited to talk to you. A lot of people feel burnout, especially today. The World Health Organization says it's an occupational phenomenon. Mm-hmm. What's your definition of burnout?
You know, it's that feeling we get when our work and our efforts are just not producing the results and the outcomes that we want, and we're stressed. That anxiety, that discomfort, that dissonance, mm-hmm. We start referring to the word burnout when we start to feel that way.
So what are the signs?
So, I mean, fatigue, exhaustion, mental and physical exhaustion, disengagement. I don't know, you start to get that feeling of, I don't know, you know, today looks like yesterday, tomorrow looks like it's going to look like today, and I don't want tomorrow to look like today anymore. And that discouragement, you know, the feelings that we associate with the feeling of burnout.
So what do you do about it? Because not everybody can just quit their job.
Yeah.
If the job is the main issue.
Absolutely. So when we're getting these feelings, what we're losing hope for is that the future can be better. So the first thing you want to do is brainstorm your goals. What is going to make the future better? So we start to brainstorm and we start to get creative and we start to look at the future and say, all right, what results do I want to produce? And then we back that up. What could I do today that's going to move me in that direction? And then when we start to make those steps, we start to get excited. And then there's that progress and that feeling of momentum. And I think that's what starts to restore the feeling of balance.
All right, now there is a difference. The World Health Organization was calling it a syndrome.
Yes.
So it's different from depression and anxiety. It's a whole different thing.
Yeah, it's a syndrome. Syndrome means that it affects each of us differently, mm-hmm. right? So it's not just one way we all feel when we feel that way. And that chronic stress, it shows up in our relationships. It shows up in our personal relationships at home. It can show up in the quality of the work that we produce. So it shows up in many different ways, but it's that feeling of just dissatisfaction with our current situation.
Why does it seem like so many people feel this way now?
I know, more than ever before, I am hearing the word burnout. It's like everybody's right. using that word. I think being on all the time, technology is not helping to give us that feeling of just taking a break, but not always the break is what we need. We need that excitement of our goals and momentum. And if we're not careful, it can affect our relationships. It can start affecting the way we treat people. And when we're not aware of that, then we start to get negative and cynical and sarcastic. I mean, if you know somebody that's extremely sarcastic, they're starting to feel the side effects of burnout.
Yeah. So what should you, well, you told us what we do if we are feeling the burnout, but what if you notice it in your friends at work, your colleagues?
You know, the first thing you do is empathize with it. I mean, we've all been there. It's a really bad feeling. And just sometimes the understanding from somebody else that you're going through that is really nice. If you have the opportunity to coach them and mentor them, what you want to do is steer the conversation in the direction of the future, right? What is going to make things better? Let's get some things scheduled. Let's do some things today. Sometimes you have that influence, especially in our personal lives when we take it home with us. You know, if there's resentment that someone doesn't understand how we're feeling, and there's a lack of empathy towards that, I mean, the highest level of function we experience in our personal lives is when we meet each other's needs. Mm-hmm. And understanding and empathy and compassion is a big need we have.
Is it a similar message for bosses and managers? Mm-hmm. What's the takeaway for those people?
Yeah, it's same thing, right? We want to make sure that we're understanding it and empathizing with it. We've all been there. But really taking steps. I mean, let's take a step back and look at what's the bigger picture? What is work? I mean, when work loses its meaning, that's when we start to get that feeling of burnout. There's no progress. When work has meaning and we start to move forward and we get excited, I think that's the feeling that extinguishes the feeling of burnout.
Mm-hmm. Well, we're very excited. When we heard you were coming on, what did my producer can tell you. I was like, I need this book. I want to read this book. Not that I'm super stressed out, but you know what I mean? Everyone goes through this, so we really appreciate you
being here.
Everyone
is burned out.
Yes.
I think there's some real strategies we can deploy to give us that feeling of balance again.
Yeah. Thank you, Steve. We appreciate you coming in.
Great to be here.
And for more information, we'll post more from the World Health Organization on our website, along with more of Steve's tips for dealing with chronic workplace stress. That's on CBSNewYork.com.